And let's now find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now with our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Good morning, guys. Here are the latest stories making headlines in the Filipino community. We begin with the family and supporters of Filipino-American war hero Telesforo Trinidad, who are one step closer to seeing a U.S. naval ship named after him.
It's a validation of the heroism of Telesforo Trinidad, who, as you know, earned the Medal of Honor in 1915 for his heroism on board the USS San Diego.
1915, while serving aboard USS San Diego, Petty Officer Trinidad risked his own life and well-being to save two of his shipmates during a catastrophic boiler explosion.
The U.S. Secretary of the Navy, Carlos Del Toro, recently hosted a celebration in Washington, D.C. to announce the sponsors for the future USS Telesforo Trinidad ship, which is expected to be built in a few years. The two sponsors are Christine Trinidad, one of the Phil-Am hero's great-grandchildren, and retired Rear Admiral Connie Mariano. Sponsors christened the ship and advocate for the continued service and well-being of the vessel. Meanwhile, members of the Filipino-American fraternity Chi Rho Omicron, also known as EXPO, are raising $2,500 for the Pinoy Pinay Educational Program, or PEP. 100% of the proceeds will go toward paying for a semester's worth of school supplies and a full set of children's books for kindergarten and first grade classes at Longfellow Elementary in San Francisco.
The four pillars of EXPO are academics, brotherhood, culture, and community. This project is kind of taking all of those into one. The brothers are coming together to build an academic structure within our community and promoting Filipino culture. So this is very much a foundation of who we are as an organization.
The books are from Bayani Art and are about the lives and legacies of Filipino heroes Lapu-Lapu, Gabriela Silang, and Andres Bonifacio. They were authored by Robin Aquilizan, who is also a former PEP teacher. And finally, for David Unlayaw, music has always struck a chord.
I'm in love with the process, making music, hearing people sing back my lyrics was the best feeling I'd felt in my life.
In 2019, Onlayaw, who is originally from Oregon, went to a songwriting conference in Nashville, Tennessee. Within 6 months, he moved there and never looked back. Spotify recently included Onlayaw in its list of top independent artists of 2022. His original songs have been streamed 500,000 times, and his TikTok video has 250,000 views and counting. Onlayaw hopes an increasing number of Filipino country fans also means more Filipino country artists like him in the future.
And those were the latest headlines from North America. You can catch our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/tfcnews and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel.